Okay, I just got back to the gym and man, I am worn out. That's how you know you've done a good 3 minute workout, if you're really worn out. You know, I started doing this when I was 69. I'm 70 years old right now, and people keep saying, oh, you just can't do this in 3 minutes a day. It's really about how you do it in 3 minutes a day. I mean, I'm 70. This works. Now, the other thing we'll talk about today is stem cells. Dry fasting is an amazing way to get a free whole system stem cell infusion by just not eating or drinking. After the third day, a digestive hormone called PKA is turned off, but when it's on, all your stem cells sleep because you're in this eating and all this other cycle, and that's why OMAD doesn't do it, intermittent fasting doesn't do it, caloric restriction doesn't do it. It doesn't work that way. It takes 3 days of 2 or 3 days of not eating to be able to turn this enzyme off. But when it does go off, your stem cells turn on. In fact, all 220 niches in your body, they all just flip right on. They go from replication to daughter cell, to transit amplifying cells, to progenitor cells, and eventually to differentiation in the cell organs in the niches. What we found out is many of those stem cell niches, organ stem cells, have a unique effect because what they do is they get in place and they start pumping out these paracrine signals that influence all the cells around it to behave younger. The other thing that happens at the third day is the release of a very interesting stem cell called Muse stem cells. These are stress-enduring stem cells that can differentiate into all three germlines. They immediately can differentiate into new organ cells right at the get-go. There's no 5 or 7 days of getting through these generations of stem cells to get to progenitor. These ones are right there, and they work immediately. And they're released out of fat cells because the Muse AT, adipose tissue cells, are released into the bloodstream on the third day of a dry fast. That's great because it goes through your vascular system, which services every bit of your body because every cell in the body has to have blood to work and oxygen from the blood and nutrients from the blood. And the stem cells are there going right through the system, repairing the endothelial wall and doing all this marvelous stuff in the heart. So yeah, the 7 day dry fast is wonderful. You can get these Muse stem cells released on a 3 to 5 day dry fast. You can get your entire body remodeled and restructured on a 7 day dry fast. And that's where this comes in. You see, water fasting can't do that. Water fasting doesn't turn on growth hormone to protect your muscles during the fast. So you actually end up using muscle tissue to provide critical ketogenic amino acids from muscle tissue, from skeletal muscle. And you notice in the book, I show the charts that muscle and organ tissues decrease in volume. So you end up out of a water fast and you have less muscle. During a dry fast, your muscles maintain. And that's extremely critical for the neogenesis part of this. Because as you build your muscles back and build your bone back, you don't want to lose that gain. And that's why dry fasting helps maintain the gain. So when I talk about dry fasting and its effects of detoxifying, that has an immediate effect on stem cell populations too, because they can be damaged by toxins and you can have what's called stem cell burnout. So what happens is the stem cells themselves start having insults to their genetics, insults to their ability to replicate, and then they become senescent. So stem cell senescence can occur by this accumulation of toxins. Everything in the body is dovetailing. Everything works together in the body. So one of the things I love the most about dry fasting is this free stem cell infusion, endogenous stem cell infusion that you just do by not eating or not drinking. It costs a lot of money to fly out of the country and have that stuff done with somebody else's stem cells or, umbilical cord stem cells repropagated or all these other types of methodologies. I don't know. Some of the genetics might not match yours. So my concern is making sure that you're able to activate your own body's endogenous systems. That's what neogenesis and the Phoenix Protocol is all about. We've achieved a point in evolutionary history where we can just about eat anything because we've survived everything and we had to eat everything. And we can turn on a lot of our genetics by making sure we have a huge variety of foods in our diet. Not any one food all the time, that's bad, but lots of different foods all the time, that's good because variety is the spice of life. It's also the spice of longevity. So my suggestion is to do the dry fast for these two reasons: get rid of the toxins and to activate your stem cells. The other thing you'll notice is you're going to drop a lot of weight because you're drawing on your fat cells to provide glucose, and free fatty acids for energy, water, and plasma glucose. So you're going to lose a lot of weight. I don't suggest dry fasting as a method to lose weight, however. It's just a side benefit of this protocol. What you can do, though, is after you've lost that weight, you can specifically eat foods that don't stimulate a lot of insulin to stimulate a lot of fat deposition, and you end up with some of those loss gains as well. You know, fat loss and weight gain and weight loss, these are really objectives of the type of food you eat and the amount of exercise you have. People say, well, how do I lose weight? My suggestion is get more muscle. Fat doesn't burn sugar. Muscle burns sugar. So if you want to get thinner, get more muscle. And that's where the Neogenesis comes in. So these two books, I think, will really help a lot of people maintain a very higher level of health span and lifespan. And you'll benefit greatly by it. But remember, it's the stem cell activation is probably the most profound benefits of the 7-day dry fast. So that's about it for today. I'll be doing a Q&A tomorrow, I'm pretty sure, because there's a few questions I didn't answer in the last Q&A. And I know you guys are putting in lots of questions on this stuff. You know, so just put your questions in. I'll get them into a list. And tomorrow we'll do a Q&A. Thanks for watching.